So, I mean, the second point for me is, we're a nation of 200 million, 70% under the age of 30, huge youth population. What does that say about us? That we have the largest youth population in all of Africa. We're a football mad country. Yet, right? Yet we are, well, given our current coach is constantly, even it's happening in the U20s now, is constantly looking for
Foreign.
foreign born Nigerians.
Wow.
What does that say about our level of development and our commitment to creating the type of players that can compete at the highest level?
I mean, I love that question because it's a topic that I've touched on so many times. In my opinion, what's it just simply shows, I don't think it says, it shows us, it's not an opinion, I think it's a fact, that we do little to nothing in trying to develop our own talent in Nigeria. I mean, strong words I'm using now, but I don't think Nigeria creates talent, football talent. And yeah, I'm even including those that were born and raised, all the Osimhens, all the Ndidis. I mean, somebody, when this comes out, somebody should correct me, and I'm always, willing to accept my wrong. But I don't know how the developments that an Ndidi got in Nigeria or an Osimhen got in Nigeria led them to become the player that they are today. In my opinion, these guys have God-given talent. And then, of course, I mean, I'm not taking any away anything from the coaches that actually trained them when they were in Nigeria. Those coaches did work. Those coaches imparted knowledge in them. But then, what I look at is that at the end of the day, when these guys still went abroad, they still had to catch up. They still had to get to the level of their age mates, at that. The way we look at Osimhen as a generational talent out of Nigeria, at his age, 19, 20, in England, in Spain, in all those other countries, even in, I'm not even going that far, even in all them, Egypt, all those other countries, the people that they consider to be generational talents at those ages, they would have done more than what Osimhen had done at that age that he was. Osimhen, what really, and again, what really broke Osimhen into limelight was his excellent performances at the Under-17 World Cup, and that's a big stage to show yourself. But then imagine if he didn't go for that World Cup. Imagine if he didn't score those 10 goals that he scored. Would Osimhen become the Osimhen that we know today? It's things like that that I just always look at. If you look at other countries, they have a very good system that, like, a young boy, a young girl can grow up, and can know that, okay, if I work hard, if I'm talented enough, and I follow this set path, then there's a very good chance that I make it pro. In Nigeria, there's no path, there's no pathway that you want to say, like, okay, if I have the talent, you might have the talent and you would not make it. You might have the club and not have the talent, you will not make it. There's so many different things that in Nigeria, honestly, just have to work all together in your favor. For example, Osimhen has said this. I think when I spoke with him on live, he said it on Instagram live, and a few other people have said it. When he went for the Under-17 tryout to make the Nigeria team, he nearly didn't make the squad. Why? Because the coach has to see like 2,000 kids on that day, and each team, they divided it, just divided them into sets. You know how we play ball in Nigeria. Each set had about 10 minutes to play. So basically, each kid had 10 minutes to show that you deserve to make the national team, And apparently, Osimhen's set was one of the last sets that we were scheduled to play. So by the time he was on the field, man, coach was tired. Coach has watched like 1,005 boys already today. In his mind, okay, I've seen who I like. Let's just finish these people. And in 10 minutes, Osimhen scored 3 goals. Coach did not see any of it. But luckily, one of the assistants, in the squad, not even an assistant coach, like maybe the team coordinator or somebody, was watching. It's maybe big field. They split the field into 6 different pitches for them to play, So was watching Osimhen's particular game. And when he was compiling the list, it was that guy that I saw, that coach, this guy that just scored 3 goals inside just this small 10 minutes. Like, are we not going to include him? And coach was like, oh, really? And that's how this thing, and then obviously they watched him again and again, But then the reality is that his first opportunity could easily have been missed out on. Another thing is that if you look at the Super Eagles squad today, you know, let's ignore the foreign-born players. You look at the home, you know, the homegrown players, the ones that are born and raised in Nigeria.
Yeah.
Any of them now, they did not look this good when they were in Nigeria. In fact, many of them now did not represent Nigeria at the youth level. If you check our current squad, many of the players did not represent Nigeria at the youth level. Even the ones that were born in Nigeria, because there is simply no proper system that identifies talent in Nigeria.